everybody, this is Josh Dueck here from Freestyle BC. We are delighted to be part of the panel for the Concussion Symposium and want to give you a bit of a broad level overview of where we're at as a provincial sport organization right now. We've been nurturing our suite of services, our Safe Sport suite, over the last couple of years, and we have five primary columns that we focus on in order to create a safe environment for the athletes, one of them being concussion awareness education. And we've been working on this in the last, 3 years to see some of the gains that we can make in terms of reduction and intervention with our high performance programs. And one of the ethos that we operate on with Freestyle BC is we are a culture of excellence and we are in the business of building champions. And with that in mind, we've noted that these interventions for safe sport in order to create a safer environment do a couple of things. One, we ensure the safety of our athletes to the best of our ability, but we also see that as a tool to build confidence. And if an athlete feels safe and well supported, then they'll be able to achieve those primary objectives of a culture of excellence and becoming a champion. Today, we have the good fortune of our Director of Sport Development, Cameron Smith, and our high performance coach, Michael Lapps, joining us to speak a little more detail on where we're currently at with some of the interventions that we have in place. And then Mike is going to share a bit of a case study with us in terms of some recent experiences that we've had and some of the gains that we're making in terms of our conversations around concussions. So over to you, Cam.
Yeah, so some of the current interventions that we have with Freestyle BC and working with Freestyle Canada is we have a very in-depth coach development and athlete development programs that go from all the way from a club to high performance level. And this is really based on the safety and the development of these athletes. So looking over courses that coaches have to do in our air pathway. So this would be air one, which is trampoline, air two, another trampoline course. This is getting athletes to start doing these flips and these off-axis maneuvers safely on trampolines, and then it's bringing it into this on snow into the airbag platform. And this also, we have the water ramps for the summer, jumping into the water. And this is the progression. So we can just confirm that these athletes know what they're doing. They can go upside, they can do these what's seen as dangerous tricks, but in a safe and controlled manner. And this all brings them to doing it on snow, and where they have to go through a qualification process before they can, you know, go off on their own or compete these tricks in competition. So those are some of the interventions that we do, just so we can secure, you know, minimize those injuries with athletes. And a big one, which is minimizing those concussions that we can see in the sport. And so far, you know, running athletes through these levels of progression, we have seen a great increase in the safety and a decrease in the injuries from doing these maneuvers. So those are some of the interventions that we have going from a coach development and athlete development side. And I'll hand it over to Mike to share a case study from one of our athletes.
Yeah, so as mentioned before, I've been the provincial head coach for roughly 4 years. And during this time, we've had maybe a 50% reduction in return to sport and concussion issues. Most recently, we had an injury, head injury, training in Saas-Fee, Switzerland. We unfortunately, he sustained a concussion in the field. And so we had to fly him by helicopter to the nearest hospital. We made the decision to do this rather than taking the train. The challenge with concussions is the athletes don't often want to follow through and admit that they're injured because they're afraid of missing skiing. So he just did not want to take the train. But it was successful because we were able to fall back onto the protocol set forth by Freestyle Canada and by CSI. We were able to implement a SCAP 5 at the start of the season, which we were able to compare the results before returning to skiing. And then because of the nice, robust protocols by Freestyle Canada, we were able to follow the return to sport protocols at Saas-Fee. So that was doing exercise while measuring his heart rate, and then also just comparing it with the SCAP 5, and then very gradually returning to sport. So going on snow for a small amount of time, just turning, no jumping. And then that was followed through with a very gentle return to training with like small jumps, no spin, no flips, And then finally, at the tail end of our 15-day camp, he was able to then go back to full training before being passed to the next camp.
What I'm hearing there is there was a lot of premeditation in advance of the camp to make sure that if any acute situations came into play, that you're able to make the best decisions in a short period of time. So the efficiency to resolve and mitigate that situation was right on plan. So we work really closely with our NSO, Freestyle Canada, and their concussion protocol, which is great. It's really a good asset for our high-performance programs. We also work with a few doctors in the community through the UBC Medical Lab that specialize in concussions to help us narrow down the resources that we want to be sharing with our membership and utilizing ourselves, as well as basically boiling down a network of approved clinicians that can help our athletes in their return to sport should a concussion happen. So what we've been focusing on recently is a lot of our high performance programming, because that's where we've noted most impacts and concussions to happen. However, we want to create more of a holistic environment for all of our athletes in our entire membership. So that goes right all the way down to grassroots. And so working with medical professionals in the community and Freestyle Canada and our coaches and our sport development director, we are building that suite that is going to be not just designed for the coaches to assess the athlete post-injury, but also for the families and the athlete themselves, so that we're all a part of this conversation to just streamline the process when an acute injury does happen. And furthermore, working with our coaches and our sport systems and coach development to minimize the risks that we take. But the reality is that there is risk in sport. No matter what sport you do, we're always putting ourselves at risk. So it's managing that risk and then creating the appropriate interventions that include everybody in the conversation, so that if something does happen, that the athlete is supported and that return to play can be expedited in the safest possible way. So that's it. That's the summary from Freestyle BC in terms of where we're at today and where we're striving to go, again, to ensure first and foremost the athletes stay safe, and then furthermore that we can build that culture of excellence and continue to build champions in the most effective and efficient way for the athletes and our sport community. Thanks for joining. See you on the slopes.
Thank you.